Hi everybody, I would like to show you guys the circuit that I built according to this diagram. This diagram can be found on this website.
The greatest hits of all time live on WDOS.
I built my circuit a little bit different because I wasn't able to get the diodes that I described here. So I was using this diode. And I bought a capacitor, but I connected wrong, I burnt around. So I was using this capacitor, which is I had. Now, let me show you guys what kind of spark it's able to produce in dry conditions. I have this welding glass. I'm going to use that as a filter. Now let's add some water. That's a much bigger bang, isn't it? I want to show you this through the welding glass again. So this is it. Now, right now, I'm using these probes to switch in between the two half of the circuit. I touch this here, I'm charging the capacitor, then by touch it here, I'm discharging it into the coil. As you guys see, these are burnt up pretty good. I also getting an arc over here. Not that powerful, of course, than that on the spark plug, but it's arching. It would be nice to somehow come up with a little piece of circuitry that it would be able to switch this automatically without any arching. And since I have this lawnmower engine where I am experimenting with, this is what I was thinking about. On the mower I have a flywheel with a magnet. Every time the magnet passes the ignition coil, its magnetic field induces a high voltage in this coil, which just goes to the spark plug normally. I would like to use this as a signal for some kind of transistor or something like it, then drive some kind of switch that would do this switching in between these two terminals. That way I would able to just use this as a signal, then the timing would be pretty much the same as it was. Maybe it would be some delays, I don't know yet, but it would be pretty much the same, I guess. And that way I could try this in an engine. So if anyone can help me with that, please let me know. Thanks for watching. Bye.